Mayhem Secretive Hypersonic Program, Air Force Research Laboratory's new hypersonic air vehicle. The U.S. Air Force has awarded a contract to Leidos to develop a new hypersonic air vehicle as part of its secretive Mayhem program. From the information that has been released so far, the experimental design is intended to demonstrate an ability to carry various payloads to support strike and intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions, and could lead to an operational platform. Leidos' new contract, which was awarded by the Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL, is a single award, indefinite delivery / indefinite quantity deal with a $334 million ceiling, according to the Pentagon's daily contracting notice. The first details about Mayhem emerged in 2020, which linked the program to the separate development of advanced high-speed jet engines. This program is focused on delivering a larger class air-breathing hypersonic system capable of executing multiple missions with a standardized payload interface, providing a significant technological advancement and future capability, the Pentagon's daily contracting announcement said today. Work will be performed at Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, Ohio, and other potential testing sites to be determined, and is expected to be completed by October 15, 2028. The initial task order is $24 million to conduct the System Requirements Review, SRR, and Conceptual Design Review, CODR, in a digital engineering, DER, environment, according to a separate press release from Leidos. The Mayhem system will use a scramjet engine to generate thrust, propelling the vehicle across long distances at speeds greater than Mach 5. It has a relatively long and slender overall shape to its fuselage, as well as a delta wing configuration together with a single vertical tail. This is of course only an artist's conception, and the design could change substantially over the course of the next 6 years. The system goal is to carry payloads 5 times the mass and double the range of current technology capability systems, according to a contracting notice AFRL posted online. The standardized payload interface would create multiple opportunities for various payload integration within the same hypersonic system. Mayhem has been tied in the past to the development of advanced high-speed engine technology, including turbine-based combined cycle, TBCC, and dual-mode ramjet designs. The general issue with ramjets and scramjets is that they do not work effectively at lower speeds, typically requiring some kind of initial boost, often provided by a rocket motor, to accelerate them to a suitable velocity first. Therefore, a practical TBCC, in particular, which would combine a scramjet with a traditional jet turbine for flight at lower speeds, is something of a holy grail when it comes to high-speed aircraft design. With engines like this, an aircraft could land and take off from existing runways using its standard jet engines, but then switch to its scramjets and reach hypersonic speeds in the middle of a flight once it reaches a speed that can sustain those engines' operation. Mayhem vehicle design could be used as a testbed that could then lead into a more robust hypersonic aircraft with an advanced multimode propulsion system. It remains unclear if the air vehicles developed under this program, even initially, are intended to be expendable or not, as the Air Force has previously indicated. In the past, the service has also described the Mayhem effort as lying somewhere between an air-breathing hypersonic missile and a full-on hypersonic aircraft in the past. As the Air Force's description of Mayhem and its intended missions is entirely in line with how Lockheed Martin's Skunk Works previously described a proposed SR-72 hypersonic aircraft. There had been a curious burst of public discussion about the notional SR-72. This included remarks from former CEO Marilyn Hewson about the prospect of building a fighter jet-sized hypersonic aircraft demonstrator that could cost less than $1 billion, which pointed to the potential that various requisite underlying technologies, such as advanced propulsion systems, had become increasingly mature. Lockheed Martin's original open pitching of the SR-72 to the Air Force had also prompted Boeing to publicly present a competing concept, called Valkyrie. In January of this year, the company displayed a model of a new hypersonic aircraft design, which appeared to have evolved from the Valkyrie, for still largely unclear reasons. Now that the Air Force has awarded a formal contract for Mayhem, it will be interesting to see what additional details about the program and about Leidos design, which could lead to a future operational hypersonic strike and ISR aircraft, may emerge. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.